Namaste everyone. I am Dr. Vivek, Senior Retina Consultant at Shekhar Eye Hospital, Bangalore. I'll be talking about retinal vein occlusions, which is a fairly common retinal disease, which is seen in generally middle-aged and elderly people. So as our life expectancy is increasing because of better healthcare and other stuff, we also see many people getting into their 70s, 80s and all that. So as we see, and off late, diabetes, hypertension, and cholesterol, and these kind of diseases are also fairly common. So retinal vein occlusions is one of the sequelae or a complication of any of these diseases. Typically, hypertension, that is high blood pressure, which is fairly common in the general population, as well as diabetes and hypercholesterolemia, that is increased cholesterol levels or increased fat levels in our blood. So generally what happens as we grow older, our blood vessels become less and less elastic. So that happens because of the deposition of cholesterol in our blood vessels. So that tends to make the blood vessels narrower and stiffer. So when it becomes narrower, the blood supply reduces, because of which we end up with heart attacks and things like that, myocardial infarction. When it becomes stiffer, when it loses its elasticity, it leads to problems like hemorrhagic stroke or retinal vein occlusions. So as you know, retina is a neurovascular layer which is in direct continuation with the brain, and it is a very sensitive tissue, where the neural tissue, that is the nervous tissue from the brain as well as the blood vessels from the rest of the body, tend to meet up and form an organ which is highly sensitive. So it is at the back of the eye like this, and this is the optic nerve, and these are the blood vessels which we can see in our arms and legs. Similarly, there are these in the eye. The larger bore are the veins and the smaller ones are the arteries. So as we all know, arteries bring blood to the organs from the heart, whereas the veins carry them back from the organs to the heart. So here in retinal vascular occlusions, either the vein or the artery can get blocked. Commonly, almost 85 to 90% of retinal vascular occlusions is a vein occlusion. So generally, as I told you, because of less elasticity or more rigidity or stiffness in the blood vessels, in fluctuations, whenever there are fluctuations in blood pressure, it tends to rupture, leading to hemorrhages like these all over. So this probably could be a patient of central retinal vein occlusions, where the central retinal vein, which is the core vein draining all the blood from the retina, is blocked because of fluctuations in blood pressure, leading to retrograde increased pressure causing leakage of blood as well as fat and proteins into the eye. Whereas when an artery gets blocked, if there is a central retinal artery occlusion, which is the main artery to the whole of the retina, vision loss is very, very bad. Sometimes God gives us a chance, there is a branch retinal artery occlusion where you can actually see a clot or some cholesterol crystal over here, and only this part of the retina is damaged. So it can present with a patch of cloudy vision, which is sudden in onset and painless. So, and that might be an indicator of either undetected hypertension, that is blood pressure, or diabetes, or even cholesterol problems. So many a times, it is seen in people who have already been detected by any of these diseases, that is the metabolic syndrome, either blood pressure, diabetes, or cardiovascular problems, or a combination of these. Many a times, sometimes we actually diagnose people with any of these disorders once they manifest with these problems. And sometimes people just tend to fall into this trap of saying that, okay, I've been following up with my physician and my diabetes as well as blood pressure is under fairly good control. But when they end up with such sequelae and we check them, we detect that their blood sugars have gone haywire and BP is quite high, which is also a possibility. So previously controlled and managed, well-controlled and managed hypertension goes undetected, because if the person has to have a severe headache and distress and discomfort because of elevated blood pressure, the blood pressure has to go really very high, more than like 180, 190. But these complications can happen at a lesser blood pressure, of course, if the blood vessels are more rigid and stiff. So these are more or less an indication of the reduced general health or the systemic health of the person or the individual. So once these things happen, many a times, like any other retinal disease, the blood vision loss that has happened cannot be reversed in most of the cases. So most of the treatment will be in terms of managing the vision and to maintain the vision to the best extent possible. And the treatment would be in the form of injections. First of all, control of the other diseases like blood pressure, diabetes and cholesterol. If there are cardiac and other neuro problems, or like the patient has been on dialysis and things like that, better management of their conditions. Then followed by injections into the eye. Sometimes multiple injections might be necessary if the condition is really bad or not responding to the first or second injections. And then sometimes in between, we'll have to supplement it with laser to ensure that the frequency of injections or the number of injections that would be necessary would be lesser. So the most important thing that we need to monitor ourselves are, these are all age-related degenerative disorders. So we need to be more careful. We have to have a better lifestyle and ensure that we tend to be healthier and comfortable, so that the risk of these diseases will be that much lesser. Just because we have a good lifestyle, there is no insurance or evidence that we will not have these problems. But the risk is much lesser, and even if it happens, it will be a milder form of the disease from which we can actually treat you and make you much better and sustain your vision for the longest possible time. So the moral is that we have to maintain a good healthy lifestyle and be under regular checkup, not ignore any vision loss saying that, okay, it might be cataract, I'll go and get it checked later and get it cleared. First, get the diagnosis, ensure that everything is fine, and then probably if the doctor feels that there can be a postponement of the treatment, do it. But otherwise, in most of these conditions like retinal conditions or glaucoma, the treatment has to be immediate and urgent. Thank you so much.